Acts really invites us to be people of the Spirit. Mm. And if somebody doesn't like that and they just want to read epistles, well, Paul's letters invite us to be people of the Spirit too.
Yeah.
With worship, we see just how integral it was to the life of the earliest church in Acts. You know, Paul believed that these Gentiles, without being circumcised, were children of Abraham.
Yep.
Some of the people in Jerusalem said, no, you have to be circumcised to be part of that covenant, to be part of the people of God. So they weren't coming to an agreement on everything, but they agreed on what they needed to make things work for practical matters.
Okay.
I had a very skeptical scholar who was coming from an atheist standpoint. I was converted from atheism to Christianity, but he said, you know, you and Bultmann are both too Christian. The difference is between you and Bultmann, you give reasons for what you believe.
Okay.
So if anybody's against that, don't blame me. But
so what did you think when that was happening?
I just figured, okay, well, now I've met this God who's the creator of everything and the designer of everything, and okay, I don't, you know, I mean, God can do whatever he wants.